Hi, it's Carrie. This video is for viewers age 13 plus. Today I've got animals from Bangladesh and India. Bengal tiger. In Bangladesh, the Sundarbans National Park has the world's largest single population of tigers. Bangladesh has an abundance of wildlife in its forests, marshes, woodlands and hills. The average male body weight is around 225 kilograms, with a length of nearly 3 meters. Their exceptionally strong teeth can grow to 10 centimeters. Red panda. It is slightly larger than a domestic cat, with a bear-like body and thick russet fur. The belly and limbs are black, and there are white markings on the side of the head and above its small eyes. Red pandas are very skillful and acrobatic animals that predominantly stay in the trees. Almost 50% of the red panda's habitats are in the eastern Himalayas. Vulture. They are scavengers that rarely kill prey. They locate food by sight rather than scent. They circle the skies looking for a corpse or watching where other vultures go. Eagle. Noted for its hooked beak, strong legs and feet, and sharp talons. The hula gibbons are the second largest, weighing up to 8 kilograms. The biggest threat to gibbons would probably be snakes and avian predators, as they are highly arboreal and often occupy higher areas of the canopy. Please subscribe and turn on notifications. At the end, you get a quick look at what animals are going to be in part two. Asiatic lion. These predators are slightly smaller than their African cousins. Other differences are they have tassels on the end of their tails, they have long folds of skin stretching across their bellies, and their manes are shorter than those of the African lions, so the ears can be seen. Mating occurs between October and November. This lasts 3 to 6 days. Dominant males mate more frequently than their coalition partners. The largest male Indian lion was 2.92 meters, including the tail. Gaur bull. Length is up to 3.3 meters and the tail is another 1 meter. Shoulder height is up to 2.2 meters. The horn length can range up to 1.15 meters. Sloth bear. They have elongated snouts. Males can weigh up to 140 kilograms and measure 90 centimeters at the shoulder. Asiatic bear. Males can weigh up to 150 kilograms with a head and body measurement of 180 centimeters and then the tail's an extra 10 centimeters. There is a social hierarchy related to the age and body weight of male bears, and only larger males mate with the females. Indian elephant. They grow to 3.5 meters at the shoulder and can weigh up to 5,000 kilograms. The tip of their trunk has one finger-like process. Their back is convex or level. Indian elephants have smaller ears but relatively broader skulls and larger trunks than African elephants. They are considered to be mega herbivores and consume up to 150 kilograms of plant matter per day. Indian rhino. Their skin has many loose folds, especially distinct around the neck region in males, which gives the appearance of a suit of armor. Rhinos can become aggressive, which is characterized by charges and horn clashes. Javan rhino. Its horn is smaller than any of the other rhino species. The male's horn measures 25 centimeters. Snow leopard. Their extremely long tail is used to help with balance in the steep and rocky terrain they inhabit, and also used to cover their extremities during the harsh winter weather. Clouded leopard. Live in tropical forests at elevations up to 3,000 meters. They are highly arboreal. Clouded leopards have the longest canine teeth relative to head and body size of any of the felids. Indian porcupine. Its head and body measurement is up to 90 centimeters and their tail is another 10 centimeters. Indian cobra. When threatened, the Indian cobra will assume its characteristic posture. It will raise the front one-third of its body and elongate its long, flexible neck ribs and loose skin to form its distinctive hood, on which are resembled eyes. The Indian cobra reproduces sexually by the joining of male and female gametes and produces eggs. Please stay and watch another video with me. I love to reply to your comments. Thank you for watching my video. See you again soon. See you guys in my next video. At the end of this video, I'm just showing you what animals will be in part two. I've just put them roughly on my bench. They'll probably get moved around a bit. I really love the wild water buffalo, and the peacocks are beautiful.